And a round of applause to you that is 4:15 and you are still here. So applause yourselves. Today I'm going to speak about the future of media, because my mission is to give the world a better understanding on how exponential technologies shape the way we tell stories now and in the future. The previous talk, it was a great introduction for the things that I'm going to say. But before starting speaking about the future, I want to travel back in time with me. I want you to close your eyes and imagine that we are going back, not in 1920s as the theme of the conference, but 30 years back. 30 years back, we are in a bar in Thessaloniki, one with the big wooden bars. You almost hear the bartender beating the ice cubes in the shaker. Lounge music, and our hero starts speaking about the future and says to his company that in the future, we are not going in a building, in an office, and we are going to work from home, and that we will have a device in our pockets that will be a powerful computer. It will also be a digital camera. We are going to see someone speaking from the other side of the world live, and then we are going to play games in vast fantasy worlds with maps and all the things that we saw today. And all of that, we are going to connect through this technology, and we are going to meet each other and fall in love with this technology. If you listen someone in 1991 speaking with this kind of futuristic stuff, you are calling him a naive dreamer or even illusional. This is how I feel now that I'm going to speak for the future and for the next 30 years. As I said to my TED talk, the concept of future is a human invention. I think that is a mechanism that we invent from the first days in Earth in order to feel motivated for the things that will come tomorrow. Today, I'm going to speak about the new media that we feel and we will share every day. So, media is still a saving grace for the COVID-induced lockdowns. There is no other time in history that we consume so much content, so condensed in so short period of time. But in the post-COVID era, the consumers of content will want more interactivity, more personalization, and if you have vanilla content, you will be easily cast away. You want things that you can control and that you can interact. Remember this Bandersnatch episode on Netflix? Something like that. So we are going from on demand to on command. And as media becomes more personal and adaptable, trust is becoming a serious issue. The perception and the definition between true and false is no machine jobs to help. But if we combine the machine with the professional opinion of humans, the machine can be a real cure to this problem. So, now we have a lot of ways to share content, to distribute content, but by growing all these means of content sharing, the inequalities between content providers and all and the ones that create the actual stories begin to start rising as regards of trust and influence. Ucho, for example, is a decentralized application that can share rights and copyrights of music and video directly to the actual content creators by smart contracts on a blockchain. Another example how media are evolving is FakeSpot. FakeSpot is a plugin that you can use and through AI algorithms can check and make a fact-checking for fake reviews in order for people to get better purchase decisions and not carried away by the fake reviews. But the future of media is human. Why is human? We are not going to a more intrusive way of use media. Right now, all the media that we consumed is 100% curated. We see shows on Netflix that is already curated by algorithms. We shop by ads that are already curated by the companies that we give permission. The future of media is that we are going to put the actual human in the center and met the needs. We are going to augment their lives. Why? Because we will have a super personalization for each one of us. Imagine that we will have a technology for every sense. Augmented reality, virtual reality, voice, we are going to smart homes. So the future of media is human. AI will become part of nearly all media that is produced. Is a commonplace right now. In 10 years, we will have algorithms that will connect to a super personalized way and give us content that we already want. So imagine that not only we are going to watching the game, but the game is watching us back and we will have constant feedback. Imagine a performer wearing clothes that are equipped with IoT and giving back data to the fans. So we are moving in a new era that physical connection and group activities, they are going to be something like a luxury. There is a lot of need in the next 10 years about physical, actual connections. I'm telling this as offline astonishment. People, we want to get together in a physical way. So, from our information age, we are stepping into an immersive experimental age. This immersive experimental age is going to give us the actual human traits that we want. We want to express and we want to see and we want to understand feelings, not just consume human written content on a live stream. So, for example, we have this Valkyrie, Valkyrie is a tech, it's a bit futuristic and dark right now, but it's a tech that you can feel, let's say you're buying bed sheets, that you can feel the actual bed sheets and how they are going to feel before you buy the bed sheets. It's going to produce virtual experiences for all the senses, through virtual reality, through optics, through sensors. This is an actual technology happening right now, and it's going really, really fast. So, still feels like a media utopia? Still, do you have concerns about how dark an AI is? Of course, every new technology, from the fire to electricity to atomic energy, has also a dark side. We are afraid that the control of biological data by authoritarian regimes, it will lock us out one day, or a super AI will vanish us from planet Earth like we Homo sapiens did to many other species. But the future doesn't come like a bolt of lightning. Comes like a cat, easily and sneaky into the living room, where until it approaches, our definition of fear, our definition of needs, our data change. So changes and the media that we consume. Before we do another travel to the future, I would like you to see a future that is connected, and the digital from the physical world is, there is no line between the digital and physical world. So let's forget our mental barriers for a second and make together a travel to the future, and this time with our eyes open. It's year 2049. As I said, there is no distinction between physical and digital. Our human bodies are connected in a decentralized web, and our digital twins are making decisions for us online. We live with our bodies and we operate our bodies, and everything that we do is media, is content. Everywhere, everything that we see, touch, smell, or interact is curated by us and for us. So, in this kind of context, imagine that we have a magic button that is the miracle moment. That you can, when you push this imaginary button in the future, the algorithm opts out and gives you an uncurated, unpersonalized, positive experience just for you. With this magic button in mind, I invite you to create this miracle moment together and invent the future of media. Thank you very much. It's okay.
Will there be more or less windows of opportunity to manipulate algorithms?
Yeah, from the futuristic approach, you will have 100% control. Why? Because we are moving forward to a decentralized web. So we are not giving the data to the algorithms. We are putting the actual human in the center. And after this, we are not going to invade into his privacy. We are going to help him make better decisions and consume better content and make his actual reality the media that he's consuming.
That was the only one. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.